here's a story all about how my life got flipped, turned upside down. And I'd like to take a minute, just sit right there. I'll tell you how I became the prince of a town called Bel Air. In West Philadelphia, born and raised, on the playground is where I spent most of my days. Chilling out, maxing, relaxing, all cool and all, shooting some b-ball outside of the school. When a couple of guys who were up to no good started making trouble in my neighborhood. I got in one little fight and my mom got scared and said, "You're moving with your auntie and uncle in Bel Air." I whistled for a cab and when it came near, the license plate said fresh and it had dice in the mirror. If anything, I could say that this cab was rare, but I thought, nah, forget it, yo, home to Bel Air. I pulled up to the house about 7 or 8 and I yelled to the cabbie, "Yo, home, smell you later." Looked at my kingdom, I was finally there to sit on my throne as the Prince of Bel Air.
Previously on The Buzz, Casey had an altercation with the Lego and is now not allowed to be in the studio alone. Clark has been trying to do his hardest, but no matter what, NAFO students cannot do anything right. Miss McKimmy is still having withdrawals about Becca graduating and has not stopped stressing about Thursdays. Danny and Levi are having to take their state-mandated work breaks multiple times per day due to the TV room being as hot as a furnace. Tyler has maintained a streak of only dating girls on the bus staff. Jonathan got mad at Cody and decided to take his anger out on a crutch, much to LA's surprise. Tripp continues to come up with great ideas but never follows through. Sam and Steve never appear on camera, but they are truly the stars of the show. Maddie had a minute and Chelsea had a chat, and now all the students are gone to be replaced with brand new faces, and that's what you missed last semester on The Buzz.